On past May, we had the school field trip to the Coffee Belt, having the chance to learn about its history, culture, and tradition. While living a treasuring experience, we specifically visited the department of Quindío, and it took place from 2nd to 5th of May. During our field trip, we visited places such as the Ucumari Park, the Botanic Garden, Recuca, and the Cocora Valley, where we did activities regarding the coffee processes. Also, we knew towns like Salento and Armenia. And we also had the experience to visit an elder's home, where we learned about their life's experience in topics like the armed conflict and the coffee growing, production, and exportation.
Every day, more than 500,000 coffee growers throughout Colombia fulfill a family tradition, one that has been passed down from generation to generation, growing coffee beans across nearly 2.2 million acres of Colombia highlands. For Colombian, coffee is not only a bean, it's part of their national identity. In fact, coffee growing is the largest source of rural employment in the country.
For 50 years, Colombia has been submerged in an armed conflict between guerrilla, paramilitary groups, and the National Army. It was a violent situation and it affected a huge percentage of the Colombian population, because some of them were displaced of their houses and others were affected economically. Now, regarding the Coffee Belt, this region was highly affected because of the strategic position for the armed groups, thanks to its potential economical sustenance for coffee growing and marijuana.
People in Salento told us that the armed conflict affected some of the citizens in the Coffee Belt. This because some are more vulnerable than the others, having fields where they cultivate coffee, which armed groups use for planting illicit crops. The coffee represents an important part of the Coffee Belt because it's the most produced grain of them all, and it gives a good sustenance for living. However, there are big consequences that come with it. For concluding this video, it's important to realize that even though we went to where the coffee is produced in the Coffee Belt, we didn't have the opportunity to appreciate how bad the situation really is. But we know that it's a violence problematic that has killed many citizens of the world.